please tell us the etymology of the word Aramaic?
Aram comes from the one of the tribal leaders of ancient Israel. He is a historical figure. His descendants and his tribe gave their title to a language called Aramaic. Where did they originate? Somewhere in Mesopotamia, not exactly in Syria. For example, forefathers of Abraham were speakers of Aramaic. They came from Ur, somewhere in the southern Babylonia, present-day Iraq. And when he emigrated to Haran in southeast Turkey, he spent some time there he was instructed to go over to Canaan. He went over to Canaan, and those who crossed the river Euphrates are called Hebrews. Actually, the term Hebrew means those who went to the other side of Euphrates River. It is not a Hebrew term, it's an Aramaic term. Abar, Ebrayan, Hebrews.
Wow.
And those relatives of Abraham who stayed in Haran and the regions there, they continued to speak their forefathers' language, Aramaic. And when Abraham entered the present-day Israel or Palestine, his language was influenced by local Canaanite language. It is on the mixture of his forefathers' language and Canaanite, Hebrew originate. His former relatives continued to speak Aramaic. It is interesting to note that between Edessa and Haran, there is only 40 kilometers. Edessa in Syria, Syriac or Aramaic called Uraha. Syriac language or Aramaic language is called sometimes Urahaya. That Aramaic dialect which was spoken in Uraha became Christian Aramaic. Whereas the Babylonian Jews who spoke Aramaic gave birth to Babylonian Aramaic. And the Galileans who spoke Galilean Aramaic, and it is interesting to say that Galilean Aramaic is the mother tongue of Jesus Christ. Soon it gave way to Judean Aramaic, which was spoken in Judea. So oral traditions of Christianity were circulating for more than two generations only in Aramaic. But these oral traditions happened to be written down in Greek. So we have the written down Gospels in Greek. But Jesus, Mary, his 12 apostles and the first generation of Christians evidently spoke none other than Aramaic language. And after a few generations, maybe by the end of the first century, Christians felt the need of further developing linguistically their own dialect. They developed, but the name they always called Aramaic. Even in Kerala, our famous grammarians like Father Arayathanal, when he wrote his grammar, or when Father Emmanuel Tully revised the grammar of Father Gabriel, CMI, they all made use of the term Aramaic. In brackets they may use Syriac, but the title they gave Aramaic. Aramaic does not necessarily mean only one particular Aramaic dialect. It can mean quite a lot of various dialects, and Christian Aramaic or Syriac is only one of them. The most important, the most developed of all the Aramaic dialects.
Okay.
It's a Christianized version of original Aramaic. When we say the relation between Galilean Aramaic and the mother tongue of Jesus and the Urahaya Aramaic, the connection is clear.
Okay.
In Galilean Aramaic, you will not find any Christian literature at all. In Judean Aramaic, they all practically disappeared in the first century. They didn't develop into a literary language. So the most literary language of Aramaic is called Syriac.
Okay.
You can call it better Krishna Aramaic. Okay.